Dear students, let's learn the chambers of the heart. The heart consists of four chambers. They are upper two auricles and lower two ventricles. Upper two auricles and lower two ventricles. They are right auricle, left auricle, right ventricle, and left ventricle. The auricles have thinner walls. The auricles have thinner walls because which receives the blood from the body. That is, the auricles which receives the blood from the body and the received blood which is given to the next ventricles. That is, the right auricle receives the blood and it goes to the right ventricle, same the way the left auricle which receives the blood and which goes to the left ventricle. So the main function of the auricle is to receive the blood and it goes to the ventricle. So they have the thinner walls. But in ventricles, they have the thick muscular walls. In ventricles, they have thick muscular walls because they have to pump the blood to the long distance. Because the received blood need to be pumped to the longer distance, so it needs a thick muscular walls. And in case of right ventricles, which carries the deoxygenated blood, so right ventricles pumps the blood only towards the lungs. The right ventricle's blood, it moves to the lungs for the oxygenation because it carries the deoxygenated blood. For the oxygenation, the right ventricle pumps the blood from the right ventricle to the lungs. In case of left ventricles, the left ventricle carries the blood, that is oxygenated blood, and this oxygenated blood need to be reached to the up to the toes in the feet or up to the brain against gravity. That means it need to reach till the brain, that is upper region, and below region till the toes in the feet. So till that, the blood need to circulate in our body so that the right ventricles and left ventricles have thick muscular walls because of they need to pump the blood to long distance. Blood vessels entering and leaving the heart. The blood vessels entering and leaving the heart. There are some blood vessels. They are entering to the blood heart, and there are some blood vessels, they are leaving the heart. So let's see the blood vessels entering the heart. They are anterior vena cava and posterior vena cava. Anterior vena cava and posterior vena cava. So anterior vena cava, just look at the figure. The anterior vena cava carries the deoxygenated blood. So first you can see anterior vena cava. So anterior vena cava, it is in blue color because it carries the deoxygenated blood. So the deoxygenated blood from the upper region, that is from the brain above the heart region, the anterior vena cava receives the deoxygenated blood from the upper region towards the heart. the blood vessel, that is anterior vena cava, entering the heart. Second one is posterior vena cava. Posterior vena cava is also known as inferior vena cava. So this posterior vena cava brings the blood from the lower region, that is below the heart. The organs which is present in the below the heart, the deoxygenated blood which is collected with the presence of a posterior vena cava. So this posterior vena cava collects the deoxygenated blood and which move towards the heart. That is the blood which is pumped towards the heart. So these two are the blood vessels entering the heart. And there are two more blood vessels, they are leaving the heart, from the heart which moves to the different regions. They are pulmonary artery. Pulmonary artery and aorta. Pulmonary artery and aorta. Here, the pulmonary artery arises from the right ventricle. So, pulmonary artery which is arising from the right ventricle. So, here it carries the deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle, and this right ventricle which carries the deoxygenated blood towards the lungs. Just look at the figure, the right ventricle which pumps the blood from the right ventricle towards the lungs. So to reach towards the lungs, there is a blood vessel leaving from the heart. They are known as pulmonary artery. So this blood which moves towards the lungs for the oxygenation, because it carries the deoxygenated blood, so for the oxygenation it moves towards the lungs. Second blood vessel leaving from the heart is aorta. So aorta is arising from the left ventricle. Just look at the left ventricle. So from the left ventricle, the one of the blood vessel which is arising from the left ventricle is aorta. So this aorta carries the oxygenated blood. So oxygenated blood which supplies to the all the body parts, which gives to the above the heart as well as below the heart. So these are the four blood vessels, that is which entering and leaving the heart. Coronary artery and vein. What is the role of coronary artery and vein? So first to see the coronary artery. There is left coronary artery and right coronary artery. So these arteries which is arising from the base of the aorta. Okay, so aorta is arising from the left ventricles, and this aorta, in the base of the aorta, the coronary arteries are arising and which supplies the oxygenated blood to the heart muscle. So these coronary arteries which supplies the oxygenated blood to the heart muscles, so which gives the blood, oxygenated blood to the heart muscles. So if there is any blockage in the coronary artery, the person may lead to heart attack. Normally we say heart attack, or it is known as myocardial infraction. Myocardial infraction. So if there is any blockage in the part of the coronary artery, the person leads to heart attack or myocardial infarction. So that is about coronary artery. Next is coronary veins. So coronary veins, these carries the deoxygenated blood. So this deoxygenated blood from the heart muscles and empty it into the coronary sinus. That is, there is a collection of the coronary veins. So the coronary veins which carries the deoxygenated blood and from the heart muscles, and these coronary veins which will be joints and to form a large vessel. When this number of coronary veins which forms a large blood vessel and the deoxygenated blood is carried to the right auricle of the heart. So from the right auricle, the deoxygenated blood which is carried to the right ventricle, then to the lungs and pulmonary, with the presence of pulmonary artery. So in the lungs, the oxygenation of the blood takes place. So this is the role of coronary veins, that is, which carries the deoxygenated blood from the heart muscles and from the heart muscles and empty it into the coronary sinus. Or coronary sinus is a collection of coronary veins and joint and to form a large vessel, and which carries the deoxygenated blood, and then it moves towards the right auricle of the heart. So then the oxygenation process will take place.